हेलो हाय स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इंट्रोडक्शन टू फोटोशॉप CS3 क्लास 7 लेसन 7। आवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज
नेक्स्ट वन इज हाउ टू मूव एन इमेज। वी कैन आल्सो मूव द इमेज फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अनदर विद द हेल्प ऑफ द मूव टूल। ओपन द इमेज एंड सेलेक्ट द पार्ट ऑफ एन इमेज दैट यू वांट टू मूव द यूजिंग विद एनी वन ऑफ द सेलेक्शन टूल। व्हेन डिजाइन पोर्शन इज ऑफ एन इमेज गेट सेलेक्टेड, क्लिक द मूव टूल एंड प्लेस द माउस on the selected part and drag it into desired location. Then your selected part of the image will move to one place to other place. Next one is cropping an image. Cropping tool is used to move the unwanted portion of the image and it work. In other words, to retain the desired area of an image. The area outside of the selection is removed from the screen. To crop the image, we need to follow the below steps. Click on the image, click on the crop tool, drag the mouse over the part of an image that you want to retain. Rest the portion will be removed. Press enter key, image gets cropped. Using brush and paint bucket tool. First one is pencil tool. Pencil tool is used to draw the freehand drawing with the hard edges. Next one is brush tool. Brush tool is used to paint with smooth edges. I will show the steps how to draw the freehand drawing and how to fill the smooth edges with the brush tool. Color replacement tool. Color replacement tool is used to replace any color of an image without losing any detail. Open the image, click on the color replacement tool, select the color from the color palette, paint over the area whose color want to change. Next topic is paint bucket tool. Paint bucket tool is used to fill or paint an entire selection of part of an image. How to select the steps? Let us see. Click on the paint bucket tool. Choose the color from the color palette. Click on the part of an image. The colored portion gets changed. You can change the background color by clicking its empty area around the image. Now I am going to show one video how to use the paint bucket tool, how to use color replacement tool, how to use brush and paint bucket and pencil tools, and how to crop an image, how to move an image. Yeah, after opening this one, first we'll open the one image. You know how to open the image. I am opening the recent one, that is April PSD image. Now let us see what is how to move an image. See, I'm selecting this elliptical marquee tool to select the part in circles or elliptical space. Now I selected this part. Select move tool and move the part. See, next one, not only this one, by using, now I'm using this lasso tool. See, I'm drawing this part. See, by using move tool you can move this part. In this way you can move any part of the image by using the selection tools. Now next topic is cropping an image. How to crop an image? Cropping means, see, there is a cropping image here. You observe here there is a cropping tool. Now remove the unwanted area. See, I need only this much part only. So I will crop the image. Don't want those all the things. See, press enter key. See, only that much part the image will be processed. Only that much part will be selected. That is called cropping the image. Here cropping will be there. Shortcut key is C. See, this is the cropping. See, this is the cropping tool. Next one is using brush and paint bucket color replacement tool. Now I'm closing this one. I don't want to don't crop. No, Control plus N to create new. A new document has been created. And first one is brush tool. See here, pencil tool. Pencil tool use it to draw the lines or draw the freehand shapes like this. See here, I'm drawing the lines. So then what is the brush? Brush is like some kind of thick colors. Thick, now
After drawing that one, I want to color this area. See, brushing. This is called brush. You can reduce the size also by right click and reduce. See, only this much also it's coming. So in this way we can reduce the size also, size of the brushes. So next one is color replacement tool. Our next topic is color replacement tool. Color replacement means, see here, in this only brushing tool. Now right click and there is color replacement. So which color you want to? This color, no? See, red color. I am changing it into, let it be in the green. See, wherever the color is there, it will fill those parts. See, the yellow color also there. So it will not go outside now. See, see, only wherever the color is there, it will fill in those parts only. Same here, increase the size also. So in this way, you can. This is called color replacement tool. Only particular area, suppose there exactly I cannot draw the same color. So instead of that one, so if you want to, in this way we can place the colors in the by using the color replacement tool. And next one is paint bucket tool. Everybody knows what is this paint bucket tool. This is, one second, see here, in this gradient below the eraser, right click, there is a paint bucket tool. Fill the color, which color you want. Selected this one and this area, see. Now next one, if you want different color, different color. Now next one, if you want here some extra color, see. See, in this way, by using paint bucket tool, we can fill those areas. This is called paint bucket tool. Next one is gradient tool. Gradient tool means we can use this gradient tool whenever we want blend of two or more colors in our image. There are five types of gradient: linear, radial, angle, reflected and diamond gradient. So how to apply this gradient? See here, open an image, select the part of an image where you want to fill the gradient fill. Next one, choose any one of the selections. We have taken the quick selection tool. Right click the paint bucket tool and select gradient from the palette. Click the gradient sample in the context menu. Gradient editor will be appeared. Select any one of the gradients and click on OK. So by using this gradient tool, we can fill the two or more colors in our image or in our document. Next one is burn and dodge tool. Burn tool is used to darken the areas of the image, and while dodge tool used to lighten the parts of an image. Eraser tool is used to erase the color of an image. Spot healing brush is used to create the unwanted scratches and blemishes, dark spots of an image by covering the area with the sample that Photoshop automatically selects from the surrounding area. By using this spot healing brush tool, we can remove the unwanted spots or pimples like that. So next one is healing brush tool. This tool also fix the scratches, blemishes and dark spots of an image like spot healing brush tool, but slightly different way. You need to select the source point with the help of the alt key before the apply. That means same like spot healing brush, but here we need to select the source with the alt key. So that is the small differences between the spot healing and healing brush tool. Next one is patch tool. Patch tool is used to select the irregular shaped portion of an image. Suppose the image is not perfectly fine, by using patch tool we can conceal it, we can fix it with the patch tool. Next one is clone stamp tool. Clone stamp tool is used to duplicate the image or part of an image by selecting the sample point in the image to be cloned. Now I'm going to show one small video how to use clone stamp, patch tool, healing brush tool, spot healing brush, burn and dodge effect, gradient tool. Let us have a look. Yes, see here, first gradient, I'm creating new one and click on OK. And there is right click here, paint bucket tool or gradient. I'm selecting gradient, then click on the gradient editor and select the color which one you want to apply. Now I'm selecting here this one and click on OK. First one is here linear gradient. See, draw the line. See, background will be like this. Next one is radial gradient. See, if I select that one, one same kind of circles will come. See, background. So next one is angle gradient. See, particular angle, whatever the angle you draw, for example 90 degrees, this is like this, see here 180 degrees, like this. In this way we can angle gradient will be there. Next one is, this one is reflected gradient. It's similar to linear. See, it will get reflected. See, next one is, final one is diamond. Diamonds will be appeared here. See, diamond gradient. So this is called gradient tool. So next one is, I am going to open Apple's image. See, what is burn tool and dodge tool? Here under down, right click here, this is a dodge tool. See, what dodge tool will do? Here make it right click and increase the size. See, as we discussed it, now it will, dodge tool will increase the light in the area of the image. So it will increase the light. And what about burn tool? See, it will increase that part. If I use burn tool, see, it will darken that area. It will darken that area. So that is the difference between the burn tool and dodge tool. See, dodge tool will, next one is there also, the sponge tool also there. See, not coming exactly. See, it's sponge tool will similarly, it will make the image like sponge, smoothness, for smoothness of the image. See, you can observe the difference here. See, very little. See, have you observed here? Smoothen the parts. That is called shining kind of thing. So by using the sponge tool, it will come the shining. See, this is called sponge tool. Next one is burner. Next one is spot healing tool. I'm going to show. Close this image. I'm not saving, and I'm opening one more spot healing. For example, see, spot healing brush tool. If you observe here, there is a pimple. See, when I click that one, automatically spots will be removed, just like this. So spot healing brushes, in this way we can remove the spots of an image. You can see here, when I open the right click and click on spot healing, we select the spots. In this way we can remove the spots. And last one is, sorry, next one is healing brush. Healing also similarly, right click and there is healing. First, which skin we need to, right alt click and select this part and click here. See, suppose you want keep this spot here. See, in this way, that is called spot healing brush tool and healing brush tool. In this way we can remove the pimples and everything. Next one is patch tool. Patch tool is under here only. See, right click and there is a spot healing, and third one is patch tool. For example, this area, this pipe is there, right? It's looking like unwanted area. So what I will do, first select the part where you want to remove. I don't want this area. And see, now if you move that one up to here, this part like this, press enter, and see here magic, that area has been patched. So you can select like this also, just draw one big arrow and move this patch, this area should be there. See, this has been patched. So in this way that is called patch. Next one, patch hill. Next one is clone stamp. Clone stamp is equal to, see here, right click and clone stamp, which part of area you want. Press alt click and one left click and move the mouse pointer here in the other place and just click and hold. See, same kind of stamp here and same image. Now I'm clicking one more photograph. You can select the size also if you want, and I click this one and I want to place one more bird here. See, in this way, right click and alt plus. So this is called clone stamp. Wherever you want to keep the birds, you can keep same this kind of bird you want here. So this is called clone stamp. So in this way, the stamp, clone stamp tool will works. Next one is adding text to an image. Adding text to an image, often pictures are incompletely without any descriptions. So this description could be anything, ranging from the definition of a picture, feelings of significance of image, or simple wishes. There can be, Adobe Photoshop provides this facility to type the text inside the image. Type tool is present in the toolbar, displayed in the left side, it denoted T. Clicking on the tool switches the typing mode. When you type mode, it is enabled. Option bar appear with the top window, providing some options and design the style and appearance of the text. So by using text tool, we can write the text of an image. Next one is type tool and wrapping text. Type tool, click on the type tool and click inside the canvas. Type the text. After entering the text, you can change the font style, size and color of the text. Wrapping text, it is used to give the defined shape of the text, suppose particular size of the text. So click on the type tool, click inside the canvas and type the text. Select the text and click on the create wrap text on the option bar. The wrap text dialog box appears. Select the style of your choice and click on OK. Next topic is layers in Photoshop. Photoshop layers can be thought as a separate films. So much like transparent sheets, each layer contains its own discrete contents. Individual layers contain objects which together create your composite image, that means final image. You can change one layer without affecting the other layers of the background of the image, so make the work easier. So to create a layer, new layer is created automatically when you paste an object to the image. You can also create new layer at your choice. To create a new layer, click on the layer menu and click the new layer and select layer option from the list. New layer box appears. Type the layer name and layer name box and click on OK. New layer is created on the layer palette. So layers means it is simple kind of transparent sheets. Each layer contains its own discrete contents. Next one is renaming and deleting the layers. To rename a layer, double click on the layer name in the layer palette and type the new name. Then automatically layer name will be changed. Next, to delete the layer, go to the layer palette to select the layer that you want to delete. Click on layer menu and select delete. Then layer option, click on S when confirmation dialog box appears. Then layer will be automatically deleted. Next one is hiding and showing merging layers. So to hide the layer, click on the eye icon present in the leftmost column in the color palette. Click on the eye icon, again show it. So we can hide it and we can unhide the layers also. To merge the layers, click on the layer menu and select merge layers option. Merging means making 2 to 3 layers into one, that is called merging. Next topic is filters. Filters can help to give a special effect of an image or selected portion of an image. There is a long list in inbuilt filters of the Photoshop. To open image, click on filter menu, desired category of filter, click the desired filter to apply. That means it will give some special effect to the object. Photoshop file formats, this is our last topic. So Photoshop file format, it is very easy, essential to choose the correct file format while saving the image. So first one is PSD. PSD means it is the Photoshop format. So when you open this kind of file, when you save this kind of files, then it will open in only in Photoshop. So it cannot be viewed in normal photo. So these PSD formats will be opened in only in Photoshop. Next one is JPEG, Joint Photographic Export Group. The file format commonly used in extension to the image files. That means the image widely used by the people. It is easily uploaded, transferred, shared. That means this JPEG image can be easily transformed from the one place to other places also. That means normal images. GIF means graphics interchange format. The file format commonly used extension for the web graphics, for web files, for web files and web photos. Then they will use this kind of formatted images. Next one is PNG. PNG is portable network graphics. It is considered as a better format than GIF, ability to support all level of transparency. That means for transparency images we are using PNG format images. So now I am going to show one video, what are filters and hiding and showing, merging layer, renaming it and delete layers, layers in Photoshop, type tool and wrapping text, and adding text to the image. Let us have a look. Yeah, see here, now I open the Photoshop. Now I created one new document and I'm going to place one object here. See, I placed one Apple object over here. And yeah, now what I will do, I will use text tool. This one is called text or type tool. See, now click here anywhere and I'm going to write the text here. Apples are good for health. Like quotations. See, I written apples are good for health. See, so when I click here apples layer, see, I hided that one. See, this if you observe this eye symbol, if I have that one, this is one layer forward. See, first background we created and later we imported that image. See, image is placed and later we created one more layer. See, that is called apples are good for health. Now I want to write one more thing, good morning, like that. So again text tool and type anywhere. See, again new layer is, new layer one is formed. Now I'm writing here have a nice day. Where is this one? Yeah, see, good morning, have a nice day. I want to change the color, then select the text and here color is there. See, I'm going to keep already background is red. So that will be some kind of sky blue color. So now see, in this way we can, now I made some kind of poster type. So what is here, wrap text. Suppose I want to bend these letters, I want to make curve thing. So but I cannot make the curves. So how can I do? By using the wrap text. Select the text and click on this, select the text here, and there is here wrap text here. Select that one, dialog box appears and like arch. See, see, now text has formed in the arc way. That is called wrap text. See, now how many layers formed? Apple is one layer. See, first I created background, then apple layer formed, then trees are good, and next one is good morning, have a nice day. In this way the text tool and type tool will be used. Next one is, these are the layers, layer palettes are this side, and here next one is, just now I'm going to show you how to rename the layer. See, suppose apple is there, double click and I'm writing here apple image, enter. See, rename it, just double click and rename. Suppose I want to, when it is in different layer, we can move, or we can move particular text. Suppose if I merge this one to down one, right click and this one, delete layer, Here if you see this, this is called delete layer. See, if I click this one, delete layer, then it will be deleted. Now I want to merge down, so because this image is different, so what I will do, see it's moving here and there. So what I will do, I'll make it right click and merge down, so it will becomes only one image. See, I can't move now. In this way we can merge the images. Now one more thing is, final topic is filter. Click on the filter and what are the type you want to give the, see, for example here, now blur or dissolve. I'm blurring the image, motion blur. See, image becomes some blurry kind of thing. So in this way we can apply the filters.
Okay students, that's all for today's class. Meet you next class. Till then, take care and stay safe.